So when you discuss ED rates of cryotherapy being around 10 to 20%, is that ED that will respond to Cialis and Viagra-type drugs or any other type of treatment? And are those rates lower for men, say, in their 50s or, say, around 50, 55?
So there's a lot in that question. First, yes, numbers are always better in younger men. Number two is the ED rates that are being quoted in this question of 10 to 20%, that would be for focal cryotherapy. Historically, cryotherapy was administered to the whole prostate, and unfortunately, almost everyone becomes impotent after whole prostate cryotherapy. So there's a big distinction between focal cryotherapy and whole prostate cryotherapy. But how we define erectile dysfunction in the prostate world is different than how the rest of the world defines it. The rest of the world says if you're having trouble getting an erection and you take and you need to take Viagra, you have ED. In the prostate world, if you have trouble getting an erection and you take Viagra and it doesn't work, that's when you have ED. So there's kind of cheating is going on in describing ED in the prostate world, whereas if you can get an erection with Viagra or Cialis, you don't have ED in theory, whereas the rest of the world wouldn't interpret it that way. People need to be careful when doctors quote them potency rates after treatment with surgery or radiation. They're talking about an ability to get an erection with or without Viagra or without Cialis. And if you can get an erection with Cialis or Viagra, then you're not considered to have ED, at least not for the statistics that are being reported by the surgeons and the radiation doctors.
Thank you for clarifying that. That's a big factor that I don't think people understand, is that they are quoting with that and they don't even consider it ED if you can work with those pills.
The ED in the prostate cancer world then means if the pills don't work, and then you're stuck with some of the more drastic measures like learning how to give yourself a shot in the penis, having a plastic implant in the penis placed surgically, pretty radical steps rather than simply taking a pill. You know, the idea that, well, if I have a ED after surgery or radiation, I'll just take some Viagra or Cialis and I'll be okay is not according to the way the statistics are being reported in the prostate cancer world.
Hey everyone, it's me, Alex, and our mascot, Hunter. You can check out his Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow, at the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and in fact, if this dog high fives me, high five, high five. Can you high five me? Thank you. You have to subscribe. Go subscribe to the YouTube channel. He even thinks it's awesome. Also, don't forget to visit our website, PCRI.org.